Hello and welcome to Poseidon Tech. In today's episode, we have two wireless IP phones from Flying Voice. The first one is the FIP14G and the FIP13G. So, stay tuned. If you like our tutorials, support our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Like and share our videos. And if our tutorials help you to grow your business, become a true member of Poseidon Tech by clicking the join button. If you want to learn more about our services, visit our website. These are the two wireless IP phones from Flying Voice. So, let's start with the unboxing. I will start with the FIP13G. Inside the box you will find the quick installation guide, the IP phone, the handset cord, the power adapter, the stand, and an Ethernet cable. This is the IP phone. Let's connect the handset using the handset cord. The device has one port for handset and one port for headset. Let's connect also the stand. The IP phone can be also attached on the wall by using the two mounting brackets. Finally, I will plug the power supply into the DC 5V supply hub on the back of the phone. Let's unbox also the FIP14G. Inside the box you will find the quick start guide, the IP phone, the stand, an Ethernet cable, a 5V 1A DC power supply, a handset cord, and a handset. FIP14G has a 3.5-inch IPS color screen and 8 line keys to access your phone lines and features. I will attach the stand. The stand supports 30, 45 and 60 degree angle. Thank you. I will connect the handset into the handset port at the side of the device. Finally, the DC power supply. Before setting up the phones, let's check the main features from flyingvoice.com. Both phones have HD voice quality, Wi-Fi to LAN bridge mode, Wi-Fi access point mode, 2 gigabit Ethernet ports, and PoE. Ergonomics design and multi-angle stand. Here you can see FIP 14G specs. The main differences between FIP 14G and FIP 13G is that 14G has a 3.5-inch IPS color display, while 13G has a 2.8-inch TN color display. So 14G, except the bigger display, has a better color reproduction. 14G supports 8 SIP lines, while 13G supports 4 SIP lines. IPS14G has more line keys and DSS keys. It's time to power on the IP phones. Remember that the IP phones can be also powered by PoE, but in this tutorial I will use the Wi-Fi feature. Initialization process has been started. The phones are ready to use. Select your language and press OK. Navigate to menu. Select Wi-Fi. Press the right navigation key to enable Wi-Fi and then press OK. Select available networks and press OK. Select your wireless network to connect. Enter your password. The IP phone is connected to the Wi-Fi. I will connect and the 13G to the Wi-Fi. Select Menu and Basic. Select Wi-Fi. Press the right navigation key to enable Wi-Fi. Select available networks. Connect to your Wi-Fi. 13G is now connected. Next step is to find the IP address of each IP phone. Select Menu. And Status. This is the IP address of the 14G. And this is the IP address of the 13G. I will connect the two IP phones on my YesStar PBX. So for more details, please watch my step-by-step tutorial. This is the web interface of YesStar S20. The first step is to create two extension numbers for the two IP phones. Click on Settings and Extensions. Click on Add. For IP phones, the type must be SIP. Give an extension number according to your setup. Caller ID must be the same as the extension number. Caller ID name is the display name shown on phone screen when the call is coming. Registration name is very important since it's the username that it will be used for the IP phone registration. It is convenient to be the same as extension number. Concurrent registration supports up to 5 SIP devices to be registered with the same extension number. I will not use this extension number in other SIP devices, so I will leave it one. Registration password is the password that it will be used for the IP phone registration. Click on Save. Likewise, I will add the second extension number. Click on Call Control and Outbound Routes to allow the new extensions to make outgoing calls. Click on Save. Click on Apply. Type the IP address of 13G to open its web interface. Default username is admin and default password is admin. Click on Login. This is the web interface of 13G. Click on Administration. Give a new password. From time date settings, select the correct time zone according to your region. The secondary NTP server for my country is gr.pool.ntp.org. I will enable also daylight saving time. Click on Save and Apply. Here you can upgrade the firmware. I will show you the procedure later. Click on SIP account. Select Enable, Online Enable. In proxy server, type the IP address of the SIP server. In my case, it's the IP address of YeStar S20. Now it's time to type the SIP account parameters according to the extensions that we created before in YeStar S20. So give a display name. In account type, the registration name of the extension, phone number is the extension number, and password the registration password. Click on Save and Apply. As you can see from register status, IP phone has been successfully registered in PBX. Likewise, I will set up the SIP account in 14G. G has been successfully registered in PBX. Let's make some calls. Both IP phones are registered. let me show you also how to upgrade the firmware. Visit flyingvoice.com. Click on Support and Download. Select your IP phone. In my case, it's the 14G. Download the firmware file and the loader file. Now we must check if the loader version in 14G is less than 0.0.10. From IP phone's web interface, go to Status. The loader version is less than 0.0.10, so we must upgrade it. Click on Administration and Firmware Upgrade. Click on Choose File. Select the loader file and click on Open. Click on Upgrade. The loader version is now 0.0.10, so we can proceed with the firmware upgrade. Click on Administration and Firmware Upgrade. Click on Choose File. Select the firmware file and click on Open. Click on Upgrade. Firmware 14G has now the latest firmware. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next episode.